Crews have recovered the body of a man who drowned yesterday. This is the fourth drowning victim in our area since Friday. The latest victim died in the Sunflower River, 2 miles south of the river bridge. 16 WAPT Scott Simmons reports the Yazoo County Sheriff's Office says this could have been avoided.
He asked me who drowned, and I gave him what I had heard.
It is the talk of the town on the usually quiet street running through Holly Bluff.
People, you know, when they hit the water, they like this. That's the worst thing in the world to do. You shut your mouth when you hit the water.
Yeah, well, you know, they just don't seem to be too bright.
The search continued late Monday with search crews from Rankin and Madison County called in to help find the drowning victim, one of five on a party barge in the Sunflower River, but apparently unable to swim very well and not wearing a life vest.
Authorities say this is the latest in a troubling trend in our area. Examples of people who get into the water who don't know how to swim, or at the very least do not bring a flotation device with them.
Friday night, three fishermen capsized their boat in Warren County's Long Lake. The only survivor was the one wearing his vest. In Jackson Saturday, an 18-year-old who was fishing from the banks of a pond. The family says he went into the water to catch a turtle and never came back up.
Not really a recreational swimming area.
Not many people come in here just to swim, right?
No, I would not think so.
In this case of the Sunflower River, searchers say it is a complicated waterway with steep banks, a swift current, and little room for error.
If you're not a strong swimmer and you're in water, it's best to have your flotation device on, secure it properly, and instances like this may not occur.
Do we know that there were flotation devices on the actual boat?
From what I understood, there were flotation devices on the boat, but was not one on him at the time.
Same song, second verse. They don't know how to swim.
Residents and rescue crews hoping that boaters and those who don't swim well will heed the warnings now rippling across the waterways of Mississippi. Be careful. Be smart. In Yazoo County, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.